when he spoke in Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 that let there be, it happened. Even this one is a guarantee that according to the Lord's own word, that the rapture will take place. But I remember too well that when the Lord's word was spoken and he said, let there be heaven and earth, they were created from nothing. And right now, we are walking on the earth. We are walking on the earth. The powerful words of God, the coming of the Messiah to snatch the holy church, the holy bride, is anchored and stationed and founded on the Lord's own word, my Lord. That the Lord's own word has power, is authoritative, has authority. That when he said that let there be the sun, there is the sun, every morning it comes out, my Lord, until today, they guarantee that the rapture will take place. Number one, the repeated non-stop visions and by voice and dreams. God tell them, glorification. Mara, I see them being snatched away. Mara, they are coming from the graves and going to heaven. He's saying, that is a guarantee that this matter has been decided in the kingdom of God by God himself. And this matter is going to take place very soon. It is going to take place and soon. He's saying that the guarantee we have that the Lord left us with is that this word, this message, this promise of rapture has come from the Lord's own word. But the Lord's own word, we know, it never fails. He's saying that heaven and earth may come and go, but the word of the Lord, the word of the Lord will never fail. So if he said the rapture will take place, it is going to take place. Let us just prepare. Hallelujah. And yet I know that when the Lord spoke, that let us make man in our image and likeness. Now you are here. You are here. All of you are here. You are here. You are here. You are here. And you are breathing. And you are normal. And you are human. Created by God. I know. The Lord's word, I know. When Kenya was faced with the worst drought in 40 years, the weather forecast, they used big machines and satellite to check from the sky if is it really going to rain in this Kenya. And everything was shut. Farmers are stuck with fertilizers. And then the Lord Jehovah, then he spoke with me in a dream. According to the Lord's own word. Then I said, Kenya, I need to greet you a little bit. So I told Kenya, I have heard from the Lord. According to the Lord's own word, he has said that however terrible and difficult and impossible it is, when I start the journey to go to Bomet, when I get to on the way to Naivasha, it will rain. When I get to Ololunga, it will rain. When I get to Narok, it will rain. When I get Longisa, it will rain. And on the D-Day, when I stand in the field, and I will, wow. I know that word. I know that word. That word, when it commands the eternal blood of Jesus and says the cripples, get up and walk away. They get up, even among the Muslims. The Lord's own word. Oh yes. When he said, let there be rivers. There are rivers, we are drinking from them today. Strictly based on the Lord's own word, my Lord. And he's now telling us that the rapture is anchored on that very word. Authoritative word. The powerful word of God. Let us prepare. That rapture will take place. First Thessalonians chapter 4, 13 all the way to 18, he says, brothers and sisters, that is the church, right? So the rapture is confined to the church. And he says, we do not want you to be uninformed. In other words, he's saying that as a Christian believer, it is your personal responsibility to make sure that you position yourself at the right place where you can receive the right information, especially regarding such a monumental event like the coming of the Messiah. So he's saying, brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about what I'm about to say, the death and resurrection of a Christian, a believer. But he's saying, it is your duty as a Christian to position yourself in a place where, number one, you get the right information about the rapture of the church. Number two, you don't get disinformation or misinformation about that event, right? Hallelujah. And so he says, brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind who have no hope. In other words, he's saying that we, the Christian believers, we are the only people on the earth that actually have hope. We have hope beyond the tombs. Only the church of Christ, I'm saying the holy church, has hope beyond the tombs. Because if you are not holy, you enter the lake of fire. Right? And he's saying that of all the religions you see on this earth, none of them has their God having resurrected. Hallelujah. And we alone have our Lord Jesus, who died and resurrected to prove that he is God and that he has power and authority over death. That is serious. And so he says that is the foundation of our faith, the death and resurrection of Jesus. And when he's presenting it there in verse 13 and 14, the death and resurrection of Jesus, when he says, brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death. He calls death sleep, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again. And so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him. According to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive and are left until the coming of the Lord will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. Very powerful right there. 13 and 14, he raises some very powerful tenets there, 13 and 14. And he says, the cross and the blood. Verses 13 and 14, he says, the rapture is equal to the cross and the blood of Jesus. The death and resurrection of Jesus giving us hope. Hallelujah. And so, I want us to look at the guarantee. The guarantee that this event will take place. The first guarantee I want to mention is this. The fact that the Lord has brought us into the scene to announce the glorious coming of the Messiah. Hallelujah. And he has brought us in such a way that it's a non-stop conversation. Again and again and rapture. Go tell them, go tell them, go tell them, go tell them, go tell them. All the time. For years now, my Lord. That tells you this thing is going to take place. So let us look at Genesis 41:32. He says, the reason the dream was given to Pharaoh in two forms, meaning twice, is that the matter has been firmly decided by the Lord God, and that God will do it soon. Hallelujah. So, this also, in this place also, you have noticed that the visions of rapture are continuous. Non-stop, all the time. All the time the Lord is speaking about the rapture of the church. the coming of the Messiah. Go tell them. Go tell them. Go by voice, by vision, by voice, by vision, by dreams, everything. Another guarantee that I want us to beg, to anchor ourselves on, is verse 15. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 15. I read it again. According to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive and are left until the coming of the Lord will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. That is serious, extremely serious. What he has just said there, that is a monument. Because he's saying that it is the Lord Jesus himself who spoke about the coming of the Messiah to rapture the church. John chapter 14, 1 and 3. Hallelujah. The book of John chapter 14. 1 and 3. He says, do not let my Bible, I don't know about your Bible, mine it is in red. Is yours also red? Do you have this kind of Bible that tells you when the words of Jesus are being said? That is serious, right? Very serious. He says, do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. Then he says, in my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? Then he goes on to say, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back to take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to where I am going. Very serious, blessed people. Very powerful also. This is serious. The words of Jesus himself, the Lord Jesus, saying that as he goes, he will come back. And when he comes back, he will take the church and take to a place he calls the Father's house. Paradise. The kingdom of God. The kingdom of heaven. The glorious heaven. God's heaven. Whichever way you call it. That place is away from this earth. And he's saying, verse 15, 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4, verse 15. He says, according to the Lord's own word, the rapture will take place. Listen to this now. That is such a serious statement for anybody to make. Why? Because I remember too well the authority and the power of the word of the Lord, the words of the Lord. The Bible is well endowed, well covered, well enriched with the word of the Lord. Follow me on this. The Bible is rich and wealthy. Look at this now. In the word of the Lord, look at this now. That when he spoke in Genesis chapter 1 verse 1, that let there be, it happened. Even this one is a guarantee. that the rapture will take place. He say that according to the Lord's own word, that the rapture will take place. But I remember too well that when the Lord's word was spoken, and he said, let there be heaven and earth, they were created from nothing. And right now, we are walking on the earth. We are walking on the earth. They were created and now we are walking on the earth. From nothing. The powerful words of God is saying that the rapture of the church, the coming of the Messiah to snatch the holy church, the holy bride, is anchored and stationed and founded on the Lord's own word, my Lord. And yet, for me, when I hear the Lord's own word, I remember too well that the Lord's own word has power, is authoritative, has authority. That when he said that let there be the sun, there is the sun, every morning it comes out, my Lord, until today, every morning the sun comes out, until today. Even tomorrow morning you can check, it will come out. Huh? The guarantee that the rapture will take place. Number one, the repeated non-stop visions and by voice and dreams. God tell them, glorification. Mara, I see them being snatched away. Mara, they are coming from the graves and going to heaven. He said, that is a guarantee that this matter has been decided in the kingdom of God by God himself. And this matter is going to take place very soon. It is going to take place and soon. God has signed on this thing. That this one must now take place. And he's saying that 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 15, is saying that the guarantee we have that the Lord left us with is that this word, this message, this promise of rapture has come from the Lord's own word. But the Lord's own word, we know, it never fails. It never fails. He say that heaven and earth may come and go, but the word of the Lord will never fail. So if he say the rapture will take place, it is going to take place. Let us just prepare. The guarantee. What guarantee do we have that the rapture is going to take place? It is right there, verse 15. He's saying, according to the Lord's own word, the rapture will take place. Hallelujah. And yet I know that when the Lord spoke, that let us make man in our image and likeness. Now you are here. You are here. All of you are here. You are here. You are here. You are here. And you are breathing. And you are normal. And you are human. Created by God. No. The Lord's word I know. The Lord's word I know. So if he says, according to the Lord's own word, that is serious. Very serious. That thing is going to take place. He's saying that the Lord's own word, when he spoke during the days of Noah, and he said that he's going to bring floods like never seen to inundate the whole earth, it was unbelievable. Nobody can believe. The Lord's word, the Lord's words of power, authoritative word and powerful word of the Lord. He's saying the rapture is promised on the Lord's own word, my Lord. Huh? And in the days of Noah, However difficult, however illogical, however unbelievable it was. But he said the floods are coming. And then 120 years, I'm twisting with them. Your finger, don't do that. I'm twisting with them. 120 years. And they are saying that Noah has something wrong with his mind. Every system is against him. 120 years. The Lord onward said, the floods are coming. Let us build an ark. The floods are coming. And then now, he continued on to preach righteousness, to get wood, and to block the places that, you know, there are so many holes you have to block so the water don't seep in. So he's busy blocking holes between wood. And he's doing it for 120 years. And everybody's saying, what is wrong with this man? And he said, no, the Lord has said it. This is the Lord's word. And then 120 years when nobody believed. Oh, it was difficult to believe that. And then now come the time for entry. Oh, yes. And then the Lord's own word now. And the Lord told him, you enter, I need to lock you in. However illogical, it is hot. And you are locked in there with wanyama, animals, and the smell of animals, you know. Then, you know, people are like, just a moment. This guy wants to angamiza familia, what? So you are entering there, and a clean 7 days, there is no rain, you are inside there. You are cooking there with animals. They are mooing, they are mahing, they are all manner of noises there. But he knew that this has been spoken according to the Lord's own word. And on the seventh day, it rained. It rained. It rained. It rained. It rained. The Lord's own word. The Lord's own word is saying, guaranteeing the rapture. I know that word. That is authoritative word. When Kenya was faced with the worst drought in 40 years, the weather forecast, they use big machines and satellite. And they use algorithms. And they use computers to analyze, to check from the sky. Is it really going to rain in this Kenya? And all of them from Europe, all of them from everywhere say, forget it. There is no rain. It's not going to happen. And then the country had begun losing animals. 2 million have died. The Kenya Wildlife Service have begun ferrying by helicopter some grass from Kitale, and they are bringing water by boosters. Water boosters, and they are pouring for animals in drinking places, drinking joints. For the first time in the life of this country. And everything was shut. Farmers are stuck with fertilizers. The researchers are stuck with fertilizers and money and farmers. There's no movement. Without rain, you cannot do a thing. And so, people have tried. They have tried and tried. They have enchanted. They have done what? Nothing is happening. And then, the Lord Yahweh, according to the Lord's own word, the Lord Jehovah, then he spoke with me in a dream, according to the Lord's own word. Then I said, Kenya, I need to greet you a little bit. And I said, Kenya, I see your condition is now tight. You are now in a corner. And there is no going left. You know, you cannot go to the UN Security Council and tell them, please, can you give us a resolution there about rain and save us? You cannot. They don't have the power. So I told Kenya, now, considering your situation, and now, I am also on this other side, and I have heard from the Lord. According to the Lord's own word, he has said that however terrible and difficult and impossible it is, that when I will start the journey, my Lord, the Lord's own word, when I start the journey to go to Bomet, Kenya, as I live, according to the Lord's own word, when I get to on the way to Naivasha, it will rain. When I get to Ololunga, it will rain. When I get to Narok, it will rain. When I get Longisa, it will rain. And on the D-Day, when I stand in the field, and I will, wow. Hey. According to the Lord's own word. So now, and it rained and became El Nino, my Lord. Aye. The worst drought in 40 years. The story of Kenya. The changing of the pages of the book. And then he now says that according to the Lord's own word, the rapture must take place. I say that word. I know that word. I know that word. That word, when he commands the eternal blood of Jesus and says the cripples, get up and walk away, they get up, even among the Muslims. Among the Muslims. The Lord's own word. Oh, yes. He said, the rapture of the church, the coming of the Messiah to snatch the church, is not anchored on some feeble foundations, on some gentle things. No. He's saying that according to the Lord's own word, when he said that Sodom and Gomorrah, that Sodom and Gomorrah, we are coming your way. The Lord's own word. And when they got there, however stubborn, however difficult, on that day, when they removed Lot, and then fire from heaven, wow! The Lord's own word. So the Lord's own word, I know. When he created the stars, every night when I stand out, I see they are still there obeying his word. They are still giving light. According to the Lord's own word. And so, when he says the rapture of the church is not founded on anything else but the Lord's own word, I said, wow, that is serious. According to the Lord's own word, the rapture has been anchored. And he's saying, the Lord's own word, he said, let there be land, and out of the water came land. We are now walking on it, my Lord. He said, let there be the earth, according to the Lord's own word, and we are now walking on the earth. My Lord, the Lord's own word. The Lord's own word, he breathed life into a molded soil, and they became a living being. And now you are all sitting here breathing, my Lord. The Lord's own word. That is serious. Hallelujah. When he said, let there be rivers. There are rivers, we are drinking from them today. Hallelujah. The Lord's own word. He created the heavens and the earth from nothing. Totally nothing. Strictly based on the Lord's own word, my Lord. And he's now telling us that the rapture is anchored on that very word. Authoritative word. The powerful word of God. Let us prepare That rapture will take place. Hallelujah. Genesis 1, non-stop.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. And God said, let there be light. And
God said, let there be light. And he's saying, when there is absolute obscuridad, total darkness. And listen to what happened.
And God said, let there be light. And there was light.
And there was light, my Lord. And he has said here that, let there be rapture. There is going to be rapture. Hallelujah. This is serious. Very, very serious. Anchored on the Lord's own word. This is very mighty. I said, I want to mine Bible here to find, what are the guarantees that this beautiful thing you have told us about, we shall fly with glorious bodies, eternal bodies, no cancer, no diabetes, no surgery, no hospital, no NHIF, no fees, no rent, no tax, no pain, no death, no sin, no lust. This thing is beautiful. Can you give us a guarantee? This thing is beautiful. Can you give us a guarantee that it will take place? Otherwise, you just tantalize us and leave us there. But give us a guarantee. And I said, it is right there, verse 15. He said, not anyone's word, based on the Lord's own word, authoritative word, whose reputation is right there, full in the Bible. Hallelujah. According to the Lord's own word, the rapture will take place. Read Genesis 2 in a hurry.
Thus the heavens and the earth were completed in all their vast array. By the seventh day, God had finished the work he had been doing. So on the seventh day, he rested from all his work. Then God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on it he rested from all the work of creation that he had done. This is the account of the heavens and the earth when they were created, when the Lord God made the earth and the heavens. Now no shrub had yet appeared on the earth, and no plant had yet sprung up, for the Lord God had not sent rain on the earth, and there was no one to work the ground, but streams came up from the earth and watered the whole surface of the ground.
Look at the power of that word. Continue.
Then the Lord God formed a man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living being.
Go to Genesis 1, 26, 27. Then the Lord said.
Then God said, let us make mankind in our image.
Let us make mankind in our image, our likeness. And now you are seated before me here. That is serious. That is the authority of the Lord's own word. And now you are seated here in the image of God. And he's preparing to take you into his family up there. As another proof that you are in the image and likeness of God. Serious. He's saying, hallelujah. Matthew chapter 24, 36, 42.
But about that day or hour, no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. As it was in the...
The Lord is talking about the rapture. He's addressing the rapture right there. That about that day, be careful. Nobody knows the day or the hour. Jesus himself is talking about the coming of the Messiah to take the church at the midnight hour like a thief. According to the Lord's own word, we are gathered here to talk about the rapture of the church. My Lord, this is serious. And he's saying, because when the Lord's own word has spoken, and the real earth is here, we are living in it, on it. And the Lord's own word has spoken. And real living beings are in front of me like this with eyes looking at me. That is serious now. Allow me to handle some people here now. Hallelujah. The book of 2 Peter, chapter 3, I'm beginning from verse 1. Dear friends, this is now my second letter to you. I've written both of them as reminders to stimulate you to wholesome thinking. Meaning there are some things I want to remind you about. And I'm preparing your mind, I'm preparing your brain and your heart and soul, because I have some serious things. I feel it's now time to remind you about them. That you may not forget some things. Verse 2 says, I want you to recall the words spoken in the past by holy prophets and the command given by our Lord and Savior through the apostles. He's taking the command of the prophets and he's taking the word of the apostles. He's putting them together. He's saying, their law, they are fulfilled. They have authority. They get fulfilled. Hallelujah. And he's saying, above all, you must understand that in the last days, scoffers will come. Scoffers will appear, scoffing and following their evil desires. Thank God he has put the two together, right? He has put scoffing together with evil. So I don't know which comes first, like the hen and the egg. You don't know which one comes first. Is it the evil desires that makes one a scoffer, or the scoffing that now makes one have evil desires? Or scoffing makes one love evil desires? But we are coming to it here. The answer is here. It's not anywhere else. The answer must be found today. It is here. It's going to be found. It's going to be, hakuna kutoroka. It's going to be found. He's saying, above all, you must understand that in the last days, scoffers will come, scoffing and following their evil desires. They will say, where is the coming he promised? And yet in verse 15, he has just told us that this thing is not based on anything less than the Lord's own mighty word. That must always be fulfilled. And now scoffers have appeared. I need to handle them. And they say, our fathers lived and died. They also said, he's coming. Where is he? Aye. That is serious stuff. We have to handle it. Our hopes are not just based on anything else, but on the Lord's own authoritative, powerful word, almighty word, that has reputation in the Bible of always being fulfilled to the letter. Accurately to the letter. Not less. Hallelujah. The Lord's own word. He said, COVID is coming. And COVID, however long it took, 4 years, COVID appeared, my Lord, and shut it down. Shut down the whole earth. Aeroplanes were shut and keys were removed. Everybody was chased away. Go home. We will call you, they said. Aye. And he's saying now here that scoffers would appear asking, where is this coming he promised? Ever since our ancestors died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. But they deliberately, the other version said they willfully, he said deliberately. In Spanish they say deliberamente, por favor. They intentionally refuse to pay attention to something, meaning they are up to a mischief. And we are not going to listen to them today. Not when it is founded on the Lord's own mighty word, almighty word. He's saying here that ever since our ancestors, they say, ancestors died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. But they deliberately, you hear the word deliberately. If I am you, I mark it. Or they willfully or intentionally. But they deliberately forget. Meaning they feign ignorance. They feign amnesia. Selective amnesia. Forgetfulness on just certain things alone. But they deliberately forget that long ago, by God's own word, the heavens came into being and the earth was formed out of water and by water, my Lord. He's saying there are certain things I want to remind you about that you may be complete. That nobody may shake you around on whimsical notions like wind blowing some kind of leaf, a banana leaf. And he says, no, we will not take it anymore from them. Because he's saying, they deliberately refuse to recognize that by the Lord's own word, there is a standard and a guarantee that is placed in the Bible by God that his word must always be fulfilled. The Lord's own word. The guarantees. You said, but the rapture you have told us about, that we shall fly. I would long to do it today. I would long, if it can happen today, please, can we do it today? I would long to leave this body. That thing you have said is good. I want to fly up and just get out of these debts here. These bank loans and what, and these houses that got burnt, jobs I lost, divorces, psychiatrists, you know, the tumors that have been cut from the body, diabetes, you know, hypertension, and all these troubles of this world. I would long to fly away the way you have said. I love it. Can you give me a guarantee? And I said, right there. Verse 15. And then he says that there are some people called scoffers. Scoffers that appear. They appeared on the earth. And their intent is bad. In Spanish, mal intención. So he's saying the following. He's saying they deliberately forget that long ago by God's own word, the heavens came into being. But if you think about the heavens, ours is called, first of all, let's take the lower heaven here. Ours is called the Milky Way. The Milky Way galaxy. No, the power, the authoritative power of the Lord's own word. Ours is called the Milky Way galaxy. And ours, as we can say, maybe a few tens of trillions of planets. And in there, the earth is a baby, is a small, a young one, a young. Did you hear the G? A young, is young, is small there. The earth is small. Our sun, the earth enters the sun, if I remember well, 1.95 million times will fit the sun, one sun. And yet our sun, we are told, is among the small ones. According to the Lord's own word, if we now want to look at the things the Lord's own word has done, they are monumental things, baby. They are monumental. They are humongous. When you just look at them, you say, I surrender. I must begin to prepare for rapture. That thing is going to take place. If this is what the Lord's own word has done, let me just go and start preparing. And yet, ours is the small one, Milky Way galaxy. Andromeda is our neighbor here. He prides himself in a few trillion planets also, tens. And they are big ones. They are big ones like Cygni. In fact, there is what you call the big boys up here, the big boys. And those big boys, they were not there before. Hallelujah. I now want to talk about the Lord, my God. They were not there before. There was vacuo, nothing. Then according to the Lord's own word, I went up to the sky. I took the 2 neutron stars. Nikatwanga. And it shook. It shook the entire universe. The Lord's own word. I want to fear that word. The Lord's own word must be feared. Aye. And the Lord took me to the ends of the universe. It was a journey. On the way, he told me, this is a dangerous place because the gravity is too high here. Here, the gravity is too high. If anyone is pulled, they become part of the matter of that planet, of those planets. At the end, it's like iron is also kind of whistling. Also, the oxygen tension is low. According to the Lord's own word, and there are many, many galaxies with trillions of planets that the Lord showed me, and he said, have not yet been discovered by man. My Lord, according to the Lord's own word. Aye. And that is the word upon which the rapture has been anchored. You say, what you have told us is too good. Don't leave us like that. Just give us a little guarantee that this thing will take place. I said, I have. Verse 15. He said, it's anchored on nothing else, nothing less than the Lord's own word, which has a reputation of being fulfilled to the letter and bring monuments into being. Hallelujah. Oceans. Can you imagine how big Atlantic Ocean is? Even if you find out the weight of Atlantic Ocean, I don't know whether you can get a Nobel Prize. It might be hard, but it's a task. The weight, salty water. Hallelujah. And all of them formed according to the Lord's own word. The Lord's own word is feeding all the birds in the sky. And you never wake up and say, what shall they eat today? You never do that. But the Lord's own word, even the lions and the hyenas in the bushes, he feeds them and gives them water to drink. According to the Lord's own word. The Lord's own word. The 8 billion people every morning, he has to wake each one of them up and give breath into the nostril, the nose. If he doesn't, they are all gone, 8 billion. My Lord, according to the Lord's own word. This is serious. The rapture is going to take place. And let's continue here. So he's saying some scoffers have come here. Let's hear what they're trying to tell us. They're saying, where is this coming promised? Ever since our ancestors died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. But they deliberately forget that long ago, by God's word, the heavens came into being. And the earth was formed out of water and by water. By these waters also the world of that time was deluged, was flooded and destroyed. By the same word, the present heaven and earth, the present heavens and earth, they are reserved for fire, being kept for the day of judgment and destruction of the ungodly. Aye, that is serious. He's saying that God's word, the Lord's own word, has reputation. Reputation of being fulfilled to the letter. That God Almighty, the Lord Yahweh, my friend, he is no man that he should lie. And he's saying, the book of Matthew 24:35.
Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away.
That heaven and earth, that is serious. The big earth. Again, I think there are some scientists, I think one of them, I don't know, they got a Nobel Prize or anything, but they have been dealing with big issues like the weight of the earth. I'm like, just a moment, for what is he trying to find it? It's already heavy enough, you can tell, right? Hallelujah. They're dealing with meta weights, metaphysics, things like that. So, but he's saying that the earth, however heavy it is, that one day this earth according to the Lord's own word, this earth will disappear. The heavens, however big, gigantic, it says Hebrews chapter 11. Now, faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. This is what the ancients were commended for. By faith, we understand that the universe was formed by God's command so that what is seen was not made out of what was visible. Verse 4. By faith, Abel brought God a better offering than Cain did. By faith, he was commended as righteous when God spoke well of his offerings. And by faith, Abel speaks even though he is dead. Verse 5. By faith, Enoch was taken up from this life so that he did not experience death. He could not be found because God had taken him away. For before he was taken, he was commended as one who was pleasing, who pleased God. And without faith, it's impossible to please God. Because anyone who comes to him must first believe that he exists and that he rewards those who earnestly seek him. I know for you that part of believing that he exists is not in your realm, right? Because for you, you know that he exists. The creepers are walking. The rain has turned into El Nino from a drought. And there is food and granaries and corn. People are living their life. A nation is moving forward now. Serious. And he says, verse 7, by faith Noah, when warned about things not yet seen, in holy fear he built an ark to save his family. By his faith, he commanded the world, rather he condemned the world, and became heir of righteousness, the righteousness that is in keeping with faith. By faith, Abraham, when called to go to a place he would later receive as his inheritance, obeyed and went even though he did not know where he was going. By faith, he made his home in the promised land like a stranger in a foreign country. He lived in tent as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same covenanted promise. Verse 10, for he was looking forward to the city with foundations, whose architect and builder is God. And by faith, even Sarah, who was past childbearing, was able to bear a child. So he's saying the following. He's saying that according to the Lord's own word, according to the Lord's own word, the Lord promised through the prophet Isaiah that the Messiah would come and that the Messiah would die for the sins of men and redeem them. According to the Lord's own word, that the Messiah, however impossible it sounded and illogical it sounded, that the Messiah would die and resurrect. Oh my Lord, when the fullness of time came, the Messiah came. And however impossible, he came through a virgin birth, my Lord. However illogical and impossible, it happened. And then, according to the Lord's own word, the Messiah went to the cross and he died. And on the third day, when the women had gone there with spices to check like this. Mary, hallelujah, he's risen, he's risen, he's risen, he's risen, Resurrected, resurrected. He's risen. He's risen. The Messiah resurrected according to the Lord's own word, my Lord. Aye. According to the Lord's own word, the Messiah resurrected. And the same Messiah, he guaranteed when he came to Melchizedek carrying bread and wine, he guaranteed to Melchizedek, and he was telling him in the valley of Shaveh, he told him, I will be back. I will be back. And then shortly he was back in the manger. And then after that, he went and died and resurrected. And when he resurrected, before he left, he told us, using the Lord's own words that never fail, he said, I will be back. My Lord is coming back. I have seen him coming back. I have seen him coming back. According to the Lord's own word, the Messiah himself is that word, my Lord. He has guaranteed and stamped it and put his seal. He who is the word and the truth. He has sealed it that he is coming. What are you waiting for, not preparing? The Messiah is coming according to the Lord's own word. And he says, according to the Lord's own word, Abraham was told with Sarah that in your old wasted years, my Lord, you are going to have a child. And it was difficult for even Sarah to comprehend. She laughed a bit. And she was told that according to the Lord's own word, next year at this time, when we come back, you'll have a baby here. And that baby appeared. His name is Isaac. According to the Lord's own word. According to the Lord's own word, he said that a great nation would come out. A nation called Israel. A mighty nation would come out. And that nation, he said, would be built in exile for 400 years. According to the Lord's own word. And my Lord, they went to Egypt. They thought they were selling Joseph. And yet they were just, that's why I said, lift yourself up and look at the entire profile. What is the importance? Hallelujah. And a great nation was formed in Egypt. And according to the Lord's own word, he said, the nation of Israel would be formed in the promised land. And so, right now as we speak, there is a mighty country whose mighty army is mowing down, my Lord. A mighty country with a mighty army. The name of that country I know is called Israel. Hallelujah. According to the Lord's own word. And he's saying that according to the Lord's own word, you that are standing here, one day and very soon, you'll be glorified and you'll fly over the clouds according to the Lord's own word, my Lord. This is serious. Very serious, guaranteed, stamped and sealed by the Lord. The rapture will take place according to the Lord's own word. This is very serious. Everybody must prepare. And that's why we are running from country to country according to the Lord's own word. That day is about to take place. Sarah is having a baby. Israel is formed. The cloud is carrying them and taking them all the way there. And then the cloud has appeared again, preparing to take some people that I know to the promised land. This is serious. According to the Lord's own word, I stood before the nations and I said, I have seen the cloud of God coming, like I said here today. And people were perplexed. People were bamboozled. People were disturbed. They were puzzled. Their hairs raised, goosebumps ate them, their skin. Hallelujah. They said, what manner of sayings are those? When we are in the dispensation of the grace. At a time when now we are enjoying the grace, then you want to bring us the cloud that is synonymous con lale with the law. But I stood my ground in the eyes of a modern generation according to the Lord's own word. And when that day happened, my Lord, until it rained on us in Kisumu there, he came according to the Lord's own word. And somebody would have asked, what kind of prophecy? Are you calling God to come kweli kweli? Is that really the monument you're trying to do here? And he came, hallelujah, according to the Lord's own word. And he said the rapture will also take place according to the Lord's own word. We see in Genesis 3:15, according to the Lord's own word, he promised a redeemer. And that the redeemer would go to the cross and crush the head of the serpent. And according to the Lord's own word, that day happened, my Lord. That day took place. In Genesis 5:24, he gave a prophecy when he raptured Enoch that he's coming. He's going to rapture somebody. He's coming to rapture somebody. And so we know in our hearts that that word is about to be fulfilled. And he's saying in Exodus chapter 24, in Exodus 19, God appeared. He brought, hallelujah. He said he would bring a redeemer. Genesis 22, he promised Jesus a substitute death. And he appeared. In Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20, he said, Simeon was told, according to the Lord's own word, that you will not die until you see the Savior. And according to the Lord's own word, Simeon waited every day, going to the temple, waiting and waiting, that one day he may be able to see the Redeemer. And then when the fullness of time came, there you go, they are bringing him. They are bringing him moja kwa moja. Nani fungweni barabara wanakuja. Fungweni barabara wanamleta. And they brought him. And when he beheld him, he said, Lord, now I can go and rest in peace. Because I have beheld the salvation you have prepared for the nations. And he say, in John chapter 20, when he resurrected, in John chapter 20, verses 11-23, Isaiah 53 also, that he would resurrect. And the Messiah resurrected. Now he has nail-pierced hands and he speaks with me whenever he wants. My Lord, according to the Lord's own word. And he says, he promised them that the Holy Spirit would come. And according to the Lord's own word, in Acts chapter 2, the Pentecost happened. The Lord's own word. This is serious. According to the Lord's own word. And he's saying, according to the Lord's own word, the grace would come to the nations. And according to the Lord's own word, look at this now. The nations, there is no name like the name of Jesus. There is no name like the name of Jesus upon the face of the earth. The name that has changed and transformed the earth like the name of Jesus. And that was the promise by the Lord's own word. The nations, all of them right now, they know Jesus. Right now, there are billions of people who have him in their hearts. How powerful. We need to go out and win more. The whole earth belongs to Jesus. This is serious. And he says, the heavens were made by that same word. The earth was made by that same word. The oceans were made by that same word. The fish that you eat. Can you imagine feeding 8 billion people with fish? That is a lot of fish. But on a daily basis, there is enough fish for all of them. Oh, the Lord's own word is a serious word, an authoritative word. According to the Lord's own word, the rapture must take place. And he's saying, according to the Lord's own word, Isaiah 51 verse 6.
Lift up your eyes to the heavens. Look at the earth beneath. The heavens will vanish like smoke. The earth will wear out like a garment, and its inhabitants die like flies. But my salvation will last forever. My righteousness will never fail.
According to the Lord's own word, we have seen very clearly in the book of Genesis that the Lord promised the grace that when mankind fell, in Genesis chapter 3, when man fell, then according to the Lord's own word, he extended a saving arm, God looking for his fallen children. Genesis chapter 3 verse 8. And then Genesis chapter 3 verse 15, he said, he shall go to the cross and smash the head of the serpent. And then Genesis chapter 3:21, that they that now receive Jesus will be covered by the blood. He shall cover their nakedness with the garment of righteousness, that there would be a substitute death. And we saw that happen on the cross. Genesis 14:18, we saw that that was the pre-incarnate Christ promising to come. Coming to bless the lineage through which he would come. He brought the pre-Eucharist. He brought the precursors of the new covenant, the bread and the wine. He was pointing Abraham to the cross. He said, this is what I'm coming to do. And we saw that he came and did it. And we saw very clearly the book of Matthew 24:36, Matthew 24:42, Matthew 24:44. He says the coming of the Messiah, the return of the Messiah will be in his imminency. Any hour that you don't know, the day you don't know, the week you don't know, the year you don't know, the time you don't know, the moment you don't know, and that is going to be fulfilled. Hallelujah. And he's saying the entire word of God spends a lot of time, the entire Bible spends a lot of time talking about the coming of the Messiah. The Lord's own word, the entire Bible, spends time talking about the coming of the Messiah. So you tell me, will that word fail quickly? Never, ever. That word will be fulfilled to the letter. Why? Because I've seen it coming. I've seen that day. And according to the Lord's own word, he has spoken about the great tribulation that comes after rapture. That is serious. The rapture must take place to roll it out. According to the Lord's own word, he has given a guarantee. And he says that Jesus himself is the embodiment of the word. In the beginning was the word. The word was with God. And the word was God. So he's going to fulfill the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. And he's saying that he's coming back. The old Bible describes from the Old Testament, describes events that are happening, that were going to happen at this time, the end time. End time events. The book of Job chapter 19, we read in 25-27. When Job saw it coming, that the day would come when the Messiah would glorify his body, and he would enter into the kingdom of glory according to the Lord's own word. Old Testament. Job 19:25-27.
I know that my Redeemer lives, and that in the end he will stand on the earth. And after my skin has been destroyed, yet in my flesh I will see God. I myself will see him with my own eyes, I and not another, how my heart yearns within me.
That is serious. He's saying the Lord's own word from the Old Testament down is promising that the Messiah will come and glorify a people. Hallelujah. And he says, Psalm 50 verse 3.
Our God comes and will not be silent. A fire devours before him, and around him a tempest rages.
The Bible talks about his coming. John chapter 14 verses 1 and 3, we have read his coming. Matthew 24:27.
For as lightning that comes from the east is visible in the west, so will it be at the coming of the Son of Man.
That is the second coming he's talking about right there. Promising it. Matthew 24:36, we read already. That day and hour is not known. And the Bible is talking about that day. That day when he comes for the church. He says you cannot tell his hour. You cannot even say, oh, I wake up today, I feel something strange. Okay, that would be a powerful thing, right? Then you just go ahead and repent and prepare. Hallelujah. But he's saying he's talking about that day. The entire Bible is full of scripture talking about the coming of the Messiah, my Lord. And he's saying, according to the Lord's own word that never fails, that word, that day will be fulfilled. Hallelujah. And he says, continue the book of Matthew 24:37 and then 39.
As it was in the days of Noah, so will it be at the coming of the Son of Man.
Matthew 24:39.
And they knew nothing about what would happen until the flood came and took them all away.
1 Thessalonians 5:23.
May God himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 8.
And then the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord Jesus will overthrow with the breath of his mouth and destroy by the splendor of his coming.
Here he calls it his coming. 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8.
Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing.
Here he calls it his appearing, my Lord. Aye. James chapter 5 verse 7.
Be patient then, brothers and sisters, until the Lord's coming.
Here is called the coming of the Lord, the Lord's coming. 2 Peter chapter 3, 12.
As you look forward to the day of God and speed its coming, that day will bring about the destruction of the heavens by fire, and the elements will melt in the heat.
Here is called the day of God. 2 Peter chapter 1, 16.
For we did not follow cleverly devised stories when we told you about the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Here is called the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Matthew 7, 22.
Many will say to me on that day.
Here is called that day. Oi! They are talking about it. All the time they are talking about it. That day will be fulfilled. Hallelujah! We rather prepare. That day will be fulfilled. Hallelujah. And he says, the book of Romans 13, 11 and 12.
And do this, understanding the present time, the hour has already come for you to wake up from your slumber, because our salvation is nearer now than when we first believed. The night is nearly over. The day is almost here. So let's
here is called the day. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 8.
He will also keep you firm to the end, so that you will be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Here is called the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 5, 5.
Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus.
Here is called the day of Christ Jesus. And then, if you look at Acts chapter 17, verses 30, 31.
Now, brothers and sisters, about the times and dates we do not need to write to you, for you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night, while people are saying, peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly as labor pains on a pregnant woman, and they will not escape.
Like labor pains of a pregnant woman. So you see now, while he's saying the time is not known, but you see the woman normally knows she has finished her third trimester, second trimester. She can tell the season around about. So this is serious. That's what he's talking about there. He's saying the signs you can tell. You can just watch your news and tell, I can tell. I may not know the day and the hour, but the signs, Jesus gave the signs. Did not only talk about the day, but also gave the signs to look forward to, my Lord. I also gave the signs. He's saying, when you see these kinds of signs, that day will take place. That day is going to take place. I have seen that day take place. The Lord has shown me that day taking place. My prayer is that all of you enter into that day and see the kingdom of glory. Hallelujah. And Jesus even went ahead and gave how to prepare for that day. That means that day is going to take place. Even how to prepare. That is serious. Very serious, Professor Kamun, my son. That is very serious. Very serious. Because it is amazing that not only did he go ahead talk about it to great length, according to the Lord's own word, that it is coming. But he also went ahead and gave signs that there will be the following signs. After that, and I know that he that speaks here is one of the signs that were given in the Bible. That the preparers of the way would appear with power and biblical stripes, calling the cloud, calling the rain, raising the creepers, announcing the coming of the Messiah. Then you'll know it's near. He gave the signs. He gave the signs. That means serious will take place. Hallelujah. It will take place. And not only giving the signs, then now he also told the church how to prepare. That is very serious. That day will take place. Can we see what he said about preparing? He even told us before we prepare. He told us from Daniel 12 verse 4 that people will receive greater insight into prophetic ministries. When he said, you seal up the scroll, because at the end people run around to seek knowledge. Many people want to know things that they watch and see. What does this mean? Hallelujah. And he said the gospel will be preached to the whole known world. Very serious stuff. Apostasy. He said, the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3, 1 and 5. He said there would be that kind of scenario in the church of apostasy. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 3. That kind of scenario of people loving the gospel of flesh. It is happening right now. But let us see what he said about preparing for that day. That means that day is serious. The Bible gave the entire cascade about that day. Apart from announcing it, also gave the signs. Apart from the signs, now gave the way to prepare for it, my Lord. Who can miss this day? Nobody, right? It's saying 2 Peter chapter 3, 1 and 8. The scoffers we have read already. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9.
The Lord is not slow in keeping his promise, as some understand slowness. He instead is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance.
Very serious. And then James chapter 5, 7 and 9. That patience, like a farmer waiting for rain, the early rain, the late rain for his crop. He taught the church. He taught mankind how to prepare for that day. How to wait for that day with maximum patience. Because the benefits, the payoff, the reward will be eternal. The consequence is eternal. Very serious. And he's saying it's never too late. Just keep waiting. Don't worry about scoffers. He said, to the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years. And 1,000 years like 1 day. So don't worry. He has said he's coming. He will come. I have seen his coming and he has sent me to you. And he's saying, Matthew 24:43, he says,
but understand this. If the owner of the house had known at what time of the night the thief was coming.
He compared it to a burglar. A burglary. To a robber. Bandito. Bakora. Coming to steal from you. And he said, you must be awake. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5.
Now, brothers and sisters, about times and dates, we do not need to write to you.
Aye.
For you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. While people are saying peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly, as labor pains on a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, so that this day should surprise you like a thief.
Look at that. So he's saying, while they say peace, peace and safety, all of a sudden like a thief will surprise them. But he's saying, but for you, you are not in darkness. You are not the ones he's coming to surprise like a thief. You are not the ones. Hapana, you are not the ones. He's saying, for you, you are aware that he's coming. Because like the labor pains of a woman, you can tell when you're finished the second trimester or whichever trimester, when it's near, even the woman can tell. She can say it's one of these days, this week. You can even hear her saying the water has broken. So, you know, while you may not know the day or the hour, but you can tell that the season has arrived. And so when he's saying landing on them like a thief is not you, it is to the world. Because for you, you are aware and you are preparing. And you are sitting here, you are live. Even Latin America is tuned in. Live. Preparing for that day. Very serious, blessed people. He's comparing it to a thug, a thief entering your house. That you have to. So all that the Lord Jesus was using to prepare the church, to help the church to prepare. Hallelujah. And he's saying, the book of Matthew chapter 25, 1 and 13, he compares it to bridesmaids. And he's saying that when they are not steady, you can be caught unawares. Again, all that was for one effort, to help the church prepare for that day. Matthew 22, the same thing. The busyness of the world. I've just bought oxen. I've just bought a field. And they're invited. He's warning again, helping the church to prepare for that day. This is serious. Hallelujah. And he says here, the dangers of a busy life in this life. And then Titus 2:13, the wicked days we live in. Matthew 7:21, 23, the dangers of this kind of dangerous form of salvation. Where you sit in the church and you are so comfortable that you are going to heaven. Oh no. Only to be shocked on that day. To tell you the truth, I do not know you. He's warning about that dangerous form of salvation. Why? In order to help the church prepare appropriately for that day. Not only did he talk about the day and announce it very vigorously, seriously, in the entire Bible, but he also gave the signs that when the season arrives, you'll see this. Not only did he give the signs, but he went ahead also and helped the church how to prepare. That is serious stuff, right? It sounds like a very serious day. And so, the book of 1 John chapter 2, 28, 29. Be ready always. Just read it. Helping the church how to prepare. Even James chapter 5, 7 and 9, we didn't read. Okay, I mentioned it like a farmer waiting for rain. So patiently waiting for the first rain. Patiently waiting for the second rain. Waiting for the crop until it yields. Until he brings it to the harvest, into the barn. So he's helping the church to be patient, how to wait.
And now, dear children, continue in him, so that when he appears, we may be confident and unashamed before him at his coming. If you know that he is righteous, you know that everyone who does what is right has been born of him.
That is the Lord trying to help the church to prepare for that day. The day that we came to announce to you. That is very serious. Serious stuff, right? Hallelujah. No excuse for anyone to miss that day. You must now prepare very firm, very steadfast, right? And he says here, the book of 1 John chapter 3, verses 2 and 3, the purity, be pure. Philippians 3, 20, 21, citizenship of heaven, that you may disconnect from the earth. Jesus really stepped out to help the church, right? So much. He really wants the church to enter. Not only announcing and showing what signs will be, and then helping how to prepare. That is being given on a silver platter with a silver spoon direct into your mouth. You're just being fed, being fed, being fed. Na kuna murija hapa that is going to cold Coca-Cola also. Huh? Everything is being given to you. I tell you. How can you fail then? Silver platter. Aye. And he's saying here, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 8 and 10. At that point now I'm switching gears. I've decided to bring in the destination also. After that, there is Revelation 21. He also pointed them to their destination. That there is a glorious heaven. That there is a new heaven. That there is a new earth. That there is a new Jerusalem. That there is no pain there. That there is no disease. That there is no sin, that there is no surgery, that there is no wailing, that there is no weeping, that there is no crying, that there is no sorrow, that there is only joy unspeakable. Hallelujah! He really helped the church. According to the Lord's own word, the Bible, he speaks so much about that day, comprehensively covered. That day will take place according to what I've seen. Hallelujah.